We have good cancer drugs. We know they work when we put them on to cells. We also have a lot of evidence that repurposed drugs and non-cancer drugs work really well against certain cancers. The issues arise when with the inefficient way in which we deliver those drugs. Studies have shown that less than 1% of the dose actually reaches the cancer tissue after intravenous administration or oral administration. Therefore, we need to find better ways to deliver those drugs to improve outcomes for patients. So local delivery allows us to deliver 100% of the drug directly into the cancerous tissue. That means that we can give lower doses to patients, which should reduce side effects and improve their overall quality of life and also improve their outcomes in relation to treating the cancer. Brain cancer is so difficult to treat because in most cases we can only remove around 90% of the tumour. So it leaves behind 10% of cells which we must treat via chemotherapy or radiotherapy. The blood-brain barrier stops drugs getting from the bloodstream into the brain. So it's very difficult to treat those cells that are left behind. And that limits the amount of drug that we can give, and it means that we have to give higher doses to patients. And again, those higher doses result in unwanted side effects. During resection surgery, when we remove the bulk of the tumour, at that point we can put an implantable device into the resection cavity to deliver drugs directly to those cells that are left behind. At that point then, again, we are guaranteed that 100% of the drug is reaching those cancerous tissues. And at this point, the blood-brain barrier becomes an ally because it actually traps the drug within the brain. So it means that less is getting into the systemic circulation, and we can have lower dose because we've went local, and we don't see systemic side effects such as sickness and hair loss. Here at the University of Birmingham, we work hand in hand with basic scientists, clinicians, clinical trials units, industry partners, and that environment helps us to move things much quicker from the lab through preclinical testing and into the clinic. We also have clinicians here coming to us as basic scientists and researchers looking ways to help deliver drugs to cancers. I find that at Birmingham, that problem-solving approach is much more efficient, where we are solving problems for clinicians rather than taking an approach of developing a device and then trying to sell that to clinicians.